Hello everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play for Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. We are just starting Chapter 5, I believe this is. Peng Lai Lagoon.
Kai's fortress.
On the hunt to get Mei Ying's ass back after she got kidnapped the last chapter.
I don't suppose they have an elevator.
No, but there is a gondola system that runs throughout the entire complex.
Nice.
Can't be that easy.
It's not. The gondola station is in the middle of a Nazi submarine base.
This guy's textured hair is looking quite amazing.
When you get back.
Aren't you
the finger guns. I can appreciate that.
What good is finding Mei Ying if you can't get off the island?
Right.
Man's got a point. There we go, swimming into the depths. So we are on Peng Lai Lagoon Part 1, I believe this level is. At this level, fucking sucks. It is probably the worst level in the entire chapter. Pretty much any level with water in it, you can attribute to being the worst level in the chapter. Mostly due to the fact that there's multiple sharks swimming around out here, and there's, like, really no way to avoid them. So the first thing you're going to want to do when you come out here is you're going to want to grab this machete right here sticking out of the cliff. And then you're going to want to turn to your right and swim up towards this platform here and get your ass out of the water. Oh my fucking god. Get up there. Okay, there we go. To the ladder, you moron. Oh my god. What is he doing? Just get up the ladder. There we go. Fuck Christ. Not a good start. But you're going to want to climb up onto this platform as soon as you start the level, because in here is going to be an oxygen tank, allowing you to breathe much longer underwater. And you're also going to find a spear gun and some more ammo. The oxygen tank is super important. Without it, you will very likely run out of air and suffocate. So the first thing you're going to want to go for is this dude down here by the fallen airplane. Fucking Christ. And see, this is the problem with these water levels, is these fucking sharks can eat a dick. Go fucking fuck off. The camera is terrible. Where is this guy? Okay, thank you. Grab his gun. That was not great. Swim. I'm just gonna head back up to that platform again so I don't get eaten by the sharks. This is going to become a problem. Okay, we got air again. You remember that you do have a canteen, so if you get bitten by the sharks, which will happen because you can't really avoid them, you can use your canteen to heal up. There's also a couple med kits later on in the level. So once that guy's dead, you're going to want to swim into this collapsed airplane or submarine or whatever it is, and grab yourself a demo charge and put that in your pocket, and then pull out your spear gun again and head toward that cracked wall that you saw in the opening intro here, which is just over here. There's another guy guarding it. Off the floor. Yeah. Ugh! Like, you cannot avoid them, which is why every water level in this game is such a piece of shit. The fact that there is no save points anywhere in the level, and the sharks are pretty much unavoidable in levels like this where you have to stop, collect items, and start again, really, like, boils my piss. you can kill them, but it takes, like, 5 shots with the spear gun. So you basically have a choice as to whether you want to shoot the guys with the spear guns or you want to kill the sharks. You cannot do both. While that thing is blowing up, I will show you that there's also some spears over here, some extra spear gun ammo if you need it. I don't think there's anything anywhere else in this little lagoon. Go away! God! There's way too many of them. Where's that platform? No! Like, these things are the absolute worst. They're so much worse than Infernal Machine. I'm just headed over here to get away from those fuckers. They're so much worse than Infernal Machine because they take so much more of your life off. They take so much more of your life off, and you can't save. Put your hat back on, you moron. So if you get unlucky and bitten more times than you want, you're just fucked. And you have to restart the level from the beginning. And again, they're not easy to kill either. So once you finally blast this open, you can swim through here to get away from the sharks. There's going to be a shark prowling right around in here as well, along with another guy that has a spear gun. I don't think there's anything of value down there though, so I'm just going to bypass him and swim up here. And when you get up here, I'm going backwards, fuck off shark, you're going to want to swim to this little ledge right here, you motherfucker! Whoever designed these sharks is, like, the fucking enemy of everyone who plays this game. They're bullshit. They're the worst thing in this chapter, and might possibly be the worst thing in this game. I just cannot fucking stand them. I can't stand enemies that you can't do anything about. And the sharks, like, you either cannot do anything, like, you can do something about them, but it's so impractical to do it, waste so much time, health, and ammo, that it's just not worth it. And you just have to fucking deal with those shits. So once you get here, jump onto this vine here. Climb up this little section here. And swing across to this platform. Indy cannot grab the ledge there for whatever reason, so just make sure you're higher up than the platform when you jump. Jump to this one over here. You're going to get greeted by a couple lovely Germans. I just go into first-person mode here and just shoot them. It's easier to do than trying to swing across with guards shooting at you. Is this guy going to come down? No. Fine. Be that way, I guess. This whipping thing is also a bunch of garbage. You have to whip really quickly in succession or you will miss and fall back into the water. Now I just beat the ever-loving fuck out of this guy. Give him to the sharks. There we go. Go eat him, sharks. Go eat somebody else other than fucking me. And thankfully that's pretty much the end of the level. It's a really short one, but it's super fucking annoying. I'm not a fan of this level at all. And just gotta walk through these doors to end this particular level. Thankfully, there's also no secrets on that part of the level, so you're on that level. So we don't have to backtrack for anything, which is nice. But so now you're done the frustrating part of this chapter, and we can get to the fun part. So you're going to notice a cracked wall immediately as soon as you start this level. There's a charge right where you saw me pick it up. Behind the pillar there, you can blow this little section of wall open. Okay, sure, whatever.
Not bad.
That fucking blast radius. It's a cracked pattern on the floor. Amazing. And in here, you're gonna find the first artifact of this chapter, the Sankai Plate. You also find a rocket launcher with a couple rockets, but it might actually be the most useless weapon in this chapter. Because there's nothing to shoot at with this thing that's worth any of your time. And you can't put it away. So you're gonna get a little turret section here. The only real danger you have to watch out for are these guys on the left. They're the only ones who really have a chance of shooting at you and hurting you. So I constantly check that platform there. They can also come on the right, but I've never actually seen anybody come on the right before. You can also blow up the lanterns too. There we go. And that's it for them. I'll take this, but it's kinda... Jesus, I better heal up too. It's kinda worthless. Of course that took damage. I don't think there's any ammo down here either, which is a really real piss off. I'll just double check, but I don't think there's anything down here, and you can't collect anything from the guards. So what's our objective in this level? Alright, access the clifftop sub-base. Yeah. So you're just basically trying to get into the secret base here. Which we saw actually in that first area. We're going to come back to the first area that we were in last level. Which is this area here. And that's where we're trying to get to up there. So you can try shooting these guys with the rocket, but I don't think I've ever got it to hit them. Did it actually hit him? Of course not. And that's all she wrote for this piece of shit. So let's move on. I don't think I've ever hit that guy with it. It's... I don't know why they give it to you. I'm assuming that they kind of maybe mean you to use it in the turret section there, but why you would choose to use the Panzerfaust over the mounted machine gun is a complete mystery to me, because the Panzerfaust would just suck in that scenario. It wouldn't even be worth it. You could use it, I guess. It just seems like it'd be more trouble than it's worth. You kill guys just as quick with the mounted machine gun, and you wouldn't have any... Oh, Jesus. Just give me my gun. Just pull out your gun, you dickhead. This is going so poorly. I'm getting wrecked like a fucking chomp out here. It's not going great. Don't think I have any water left, either. Barely. Jesus Christ. I need a med kit. So once you get up top here, there's a ladder to climb the rest of the way up. And we get a nice little zipline section here. So pull out your whip and zipline across. Sometimes it takes a little shimmy in to kind of get it right. Okay. That's absolutely not where I wanted to go. I didn't even know you could get down there. Did I just fuck myself over? Probably. I didn't even know you could fall in the water. I just assumed if you fall in the water, you just died. So this must have come down since we started this level. Because it makes no sense. Jesus. It makes no sense that they would offer... Oh, fuck you. How are there so many guys? Enough of that. Jesus. We are living on a prayer here, people. This is not going well. Thank God he didn't shoot that barrel, or I would have been fucking pissed. I think there's a med kit in here, though. Neither one of these boxes are in the hut. There we go. That's what I need. Nice. So after you dispose of those guys, head in here and see what's inside. I don't think there's much in here. Oh, is there nothing in here? It's just a chair. Just a chair to use as a weapon, I guess. So what you're actually supposed to do... is climb up this ladder here. And we gotta grab that platform out in the water there and swing it over so we have a place to jump to. So all you gotta do is move the crane to the right once, I believe, and it automatically goes to the platform. Hit control to pick it up. And then swing it as far left and move it as far upward as you can. And that's pretty much it for this puzzle. And just swing her over here. Okay, perfect. There's no, like, victory scene or something like that telling you you've done it right. You just have to trial and error it, but that is the right way to do it, is to put it as high and as far to the right as possible. Okay, now let's hope I don't fuck this up and fall into the water, because that would be a real pain in my ass. Perfect. Okay, and then you just make one last jump. Nice. We did it! God, if I had missed that jump, that would have sucked so bad. I don't think there's anything around here. Nope, so we can enter the sub-base. And just to be cheeky, they made it so you had to activate a lever and not just open the door for some dumb reason. We are in the U-boat base now. And this is where things get ugly. I may die here. Oh, at least I start with full health. Maybe that's because I healed up? I don't know. Yeah, I have no water. There's no fountains, I don't think, in this entire chapter. You're going to be relying entirely on medkits. Oh, God.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Don't we all? So this, this one... level introduces the first alarm system in the game, which is a real pain in my ass. I'm just gonna jump in the water here really quick. Swim over here, because I believe there's a box with some ammo in it. So jank. I don't remember this game being so fucking jank with the platforming. I guess it is a 2003 game, but whatever. So you get some MP40 ammo. That's the only thing down here for now. We are trying to get into that other area where the sub is at. That guy see me. Probably did. Okay, maybe not. Oh, is there anybody in here? Ah, fuck. So somebody saw me, and that's the alarm, which means that people with flamethrowers are going to be coming down and wrecking my shit. You can hear them already, and I don't have anything to fight them with. So I think we're fucked already. I don't know how I'm supposed to beat these guys. You can shoot them, I guess? Okay, there we go. He's dead. This is not going as well as my first run here. So in order to turn off the alarm system, you need to find the alarm, which I think is pretty far away. There's another guy with a panther. Perfect. God, isn't this fun? I don't think you can even punch them, so I think I'm fucked. Let me in. Get me away from this fucking dude. I need to find a weapon of some sort. Good lord. God, he's still following me. Oh, this is terrible. I'm fucked. Okay, yeah. That was just a terrible run from start to finish. That was just fucked. We had another guy come in. I was just fucked. I was done. Now we have to try and hide ourselves from a random dude walking by. I can never tell, like, where they fucking are, because the camera is not great. So is there anything, any reason to come in here whatsoever? Sure doesn't look like it. Nice. Oh, fuck me. Quit blocking all my fucking punches, you jackass. Okay, at least you never got you in the line. And up here, there's a nice little med kit for ya. Don't you dare. Oh, you fucker. Get the fuck out of here! I hate this level. I hate this chapter. Nice. Just sit there in a daze while fire people are coming at you. No, I'm not a fan of this chapter. It's not very fun. I don't like it. I just hate stealth. This game, it does not... Like, it doesn't function well enough for stealth. Wick, where did this dude come from? Where even is he? Ugh. This is such a bag of dicks. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Better heal up, because fire dude's coming. Like, where are... Okay, like, fucking Christ. It's just a camera, and just everything does not lend itself to be a stealth game whatsoever. Fuck, is this disgusting stuff. Is there anything in that room I missed? Like, I don't even remember what I'm trying to show at this point. I may have to just re-record this whole fucking thing. I don't know. Right, here's the second artifact. Good thing that we came back here. This is such a mess, this fucking chapter at this point. I should have just recorded at a different time. But anyway, let's keep moving. So that's where the second artifact is, up in that little room there. Fuck this garbage. So this is going to lead you down here. I think this is a dead end, but there's a door down here. That's the main door, I think. Yeah, I think that's where we're supposed to go. Where did you come from? I think in here is where you finally get an MP40. Yes. Which makes this level a whole lot easier. When you have access to an MP40. Okay. Let's keep moving. Because I just want to get this chapter done. So now we are in the second part of the base.
You've got to be kidding me.
Like, who saw me there? Who fucking saw me? You? Eat shit. So now we got more flamethrower guys coming. Shut that shit out. Where's the fire dudes? That. Where the hell are you? I'm fucking sick of this level. I want out. Okay. So that's the exit. I think there is a little something under the boat down here, though. Possibly a med. Oh, there we go. Some revolver ammo. Mauser ammo, sorry. So you can grab that if you want, and let's keep moving on. Let's leave this level far fucking behind, because I don't want to deal with it. That was terrible. That was the worst, like, way that level could have possibly gone, I suppose. But now we get a cutscene.
You have brought the third shot of the mirror. Good. The stars are in perfect alignment.
Why would this guy bring his two women with him?
Don't be so hasty, Marshal Kai, or whatever it is.
Is it just a power play? Maybe.
That is still the matter of the American.
Maybe it's just a power play.
Jones, the man you sent to Prague to steal the second piece from me.
Oh,
you have violated our agreement.
Nonsense. If you are not so incompetent, I would have had no need of Jones. He accomplished more in 2 weeks than you have in the last 2 years.
Watch your tongue!
Get fucked.
I advise you to remember whom you are speaking to and who I represent.
It is you who will watch your tongue while you are on my island. I allowed you to construct this facility in exchange for German weaponry. But the heart of the dragon is a separate matter. Your Führer will have the heart once I have control of China. Until then, don't forget where you stand in the order of things.
Dun dun dun.
That one can't be trusted.
No, he cannot. He must be eliminated as soon as the heart of the dragon has been recovered. I shall see to it personally.
Why not just kill him now? You have all three of the pieces of the Mirror Dreams. What do you need him for? Maybe there's a reason later on, I can't remember. Dun dun dun!
Halt! Zurück zum Posten!
Your papers, I know what I'm in here. Go ahead.
That's the way to the gondola station. If I have the right change of clothes, I might even get a ride.
So, that's a little hint that you need to get an officer's uniform from somewhere before we can access the gondola station. God, I hope this one goes better than the last chapter. So you can come up here. There's alarm systems here, too, if you haven't noticed this guy running like his life depended on it. There's alarm systems in this level as well. I fucking hate them. I think they're a really poor addition to the game. Yeah, whip him. Whip the shit out of him. So these guys, I think, are like extra guards. They're like extra tough guards or whatever that it's a harder, a little harder for Indy to bring down. Like, I mean, he can take two gunshots through a table and a bunch of bottles of wine. The man can probably take a little bit of a beating. Okay. Some MP40 ammo, another Mauser. Perfect. So down here, it's just, there's the, another alarm. Down here is just the door that you could have used to get in. You can use either way, doesn't matter. That door's locked. You're not going to be able to get through it. So either way, the door or the ladder lead to the same place. So to continue forward, go through these doors here. Our main objective in this level is to find a way into the U-boat pens, where we will find an officer uniform to get past the gate there. Is there a dude here? There it is. Let's do some sneaking. Correct. You never saw anything, and I will take your MP40 for you. Is anyone on this side? Get a good old spin. Nope. No one on this side. So, let's enter this big yard of shit. So, we come to another turret section. And he's pulled the alarm, so you are gonna have guys kind of coming out the belfry here. Where was the next dude? I don't think you get flamethrower guys on this particular level. I think it's just regular guards. And once you shoot enough, the gate will open. But you're not done yet. You gotta basically keep shooting them until you find an opening big enough to turn off the alarm, which does take a while. Oh, nice. Do I not have any medkits? Are you kidding me? Fucking Christ. Well, this is not gonna be great. Is that it? Alright, I think that's it. And I need to find a medkit desperately. Jesus Christ. Please tell me there's a medkit in this box back here.
I'll try not to blow myself up.
Wow. Just about as useless as you could possibly get. I think there's a medkit in the back of the truck. But I also think there's other dudes wandering around back here. Can't remember. So we can't get in there, but we need to get, I think there's a medkit back here. Thank God. Oof. Okay, and there's some MP40. So we need to get in there because that's going to open up the ventilation system on this side of the wall here, which is where we need to get into the next level. We need to get in there. So in order to do that, I don't think there's anything on the roof here. Doesn't look like it, no. Just where dudes come to kill you. So we need to get that grate open to get into the vents. So what you have to do is hop across this truck. It's like our old days in Babylon from Infernal Machine. And then you can get in here through the top ventilation shaft is open. Pull the lever, that'll open the grate, and that is our way out of here. But there's going to be a couple dudes now. No, I do not want fucking useless grenade. Do you want me to die? So there's gonna be a couple dudes back here. Two of them, I believe. No, just the one. Maybe just the one. Is there another one up here? No? Okay. Okay, I guess it was just the one. And then you get up here and just drop through the hole, and we are on to the U-boat base part 2, I believe. This is a longer chapter than I remember. U-boat base part 2. So we gotta make our way to the gondola station, locate a disguise and some security papers for us, and bluff your way past the security checkpoint. All we really have to do is find the disguise and the security papers. The rest is done in the cutscene, unfortunately. So run forward, and you're going to find a medkit, some MP4 ammo, and just this bottle. Someone was apparently drinking down here, neglecting his duties like a chump. But, oh well. It is what it is. So you got to use the ventilation shaft to get into the U-boat base down here. So this one does indeed have flamethrower guards again. My favorite, right? So much fun. So when you drop down here, actually the first thing you're going to want to do is go to the left here and drop off this platform and drop down here. Because back here behind these boxes is actually going to be your third artifact of the chapter, the Tablet of Longjian. And that's the last artifact in this chapter. So the first one was on the second level. The second one was on the third level, I believe, that awful one with all the alarms. And the final one is on this level, which is the last level of the chapter, I believe. So jump in the water here, because you can't, unfortunately, get back up the way you came. And I believe there is a ladder around here somewhere. I'm just checking the grounds to see if there's anything. It doesn't look like there's anything on the bottom, but here's the ladder we need. So climb up here. Once again, like, there's alarm systems everywhere, so just be wary that guards can pull the alarms and you will get the flame guys again. But at least now we have the MP40, which can deal with them pretty quickly. So hopefully it won't be as bad. This takes us back up here, where we got... My luck has run out, has it? The one German guard. Got crushed against the door. Perfect. Again, alarm system. You can pull it yourself. If you're feeling extra bold, go for it, I guess. I'm not going to tell you one way or the other. So come all the way as far right as you can from where you enter. And you're going to find this lever that will move that post there. Oh, you prick. No one heard anything false. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well... Fuck you guys. Nice, killed your own dude. What a fucking prick. Fly out the window, you piece of shit. So we'll probably still get some flame guys, I'm sure. Even if they just pull it once, they always seem to have enough time to get ready and come forward with us. So this leads back down here. There's nothing to do down here except just climb back up. What we're headed for is where we moved those rafters with the lever here. Because now we can whip across to the other side. And get up here. And over here, you piece of shit. I thought for a second I said I'll put my butt up your boot, and I was having a good chuckle at it. So up here you're gonna find the security passes. Can't go through there, but thankfully the officer clothes are pretty close by. Oh, everyone runs like a fucking ape. Just for running, I'm gonna shoot you. Come down here into this area, and you are going to... Oh, get shot. Oh, Jesus. That guy meant business. Who is that? Like, I can't even see. How am I supposed to shoot him? Fucking ridiculous. Okay, where are you, prick? There's my officer uniforms.
Like a man in uniform. I think this is probably an exception.
Maybe I can slide past them now without anybody knowing. Anybody knowing that I was the one who the alarm was pulled for. I guess we can't keep the machete. I don't even know where that guy pulled the alarm. Where did he go? Maybe they disappear once you're in uniform? I don't know. Either way, once you get your outfit, you can come right out here. Hey! Nothing suspicious going on here, and just walk right past these guys to the exit. And that will end the level. And the chapter,
Sergeant,
as well.
Colonel Siemens requires a special messenger to deliver a high security letter to Herr von Beck. A
motorcycle
is waiting out front to take you to the command center. Sergeant, aren't you forgetting something?
Oh, get on with it.
God, that must be the most awkward conversation ever. Just riding with a Nazi the whole way there. But anyway, yeah, that is the end of Peng Lai Lagoon, and we are now in Peng Lai Mountains. So that's a good place to cut it. Finished chapter 5. Really not one of my favorite chapters, as you could tell. I just really feel like the stealth aspect does not work for this game whatsoever. There's just no way with the janky controls and the janky camera to creep around the place and try not to get caught. It's more a matter of luck than anything else. And it really sucks in that third level where you have nothing really to shoot. To shoot the flamethrower guards with. It gets a little bit better later on once you get the MP40 because that takes care of them pretty quickly. But that third level and that first level also are real pains in the ass, and I'm not a fan of them. So we are done with those, and we are on to Peng Lai Mountains. I hope you enjoyed this video and the little bit of rage that came out of it. And we'll see you in the next video. Take care.